Now, assuming this explanation for a lunar eclipse, that is, the explanation that it's caused by the moon entering the Earth's shadow, Aristotle gives an argument for why the Earth must be spherical and not flat. He writes, "How else would eclipses of the moon show segments shaped as we see them? As it is, the shapes which the moon itself each month shows," he's referring to the different phases of the moon here, "the different phases of the moon are of every kind. They are straight," referring to the half moon, "gibbous, and concave or crescent shaped. But in eclipses, the outline is always curved. And since it's the interposition or intervention of the Earth between the Sun and the Moon which causes the lunar eclipse, the shape of the Earth's shadow on the Moon will be caused by the shape of the Earth's surface, or the shape of the Earth's shadow on the Moon will reflect the shape of the Earth's surface, and so the Earth's surface must be spherical. If you look at the boundary of the shadow cast by the Earth on the Moon's surface during a lunar eclipse, you will see that the boundary is curved. And this dark region up here appears to be circular in shape, though we don't see its full boundary. Now, based on such well-accepted observations, Aristotle argues that the Earth, which casts such a circular shadow on the Moon, must be spherical. So think about it for a moment. Is this argument valid? Remember that the person who supposedly came up with the right explanation for a lunar eclipse, that is Anaxagoras also believed that the Earth was flat. So how could he believe the Earth was flat if he also noted that the boundary of the Earth's shadow on the Moon was curved? Well, we don't have Anaxagoras' original works, so we can only speculate here. Note, however, that even if the Earth was flat, it is possible for the Earth's shadow on the Moon to be circular. And that is possible if the Earth is a flat but round or circular disk. This was in fact a commonly accepted shape of the flat Earth, as we have seen before. So in this picture, imagine the Moon to be directly above the Earth and the Sun to be directly below the Earth. And imagine the Earth blocking the Sun's light from falling on the Moon. So the Sun's light is coming from below, and the Earth blocks that sunlight from falling on the Moon, which is above the Earth. If you are located on this flat Earth, somewhere on the land, you will see a full Moon, and when the lunar eclipse starts, you will see the full Moon progressively entering the Earth's shadow. And the outline of that shadow will be circular, as we've seen in a prior video. So it's not contradictory to believe that the Earth is flat and to simultaneously believe that a lunar eclipse is caused by the Moon entering the Earth's shadow.